Okay, now we have come to video number 3. Let's continue with our hedging. Just now we have done the long hedge or buying hedge. Now let's do the short or selling hedge. Okay, so when we talk about selling hedge or short hedge, we are talking about the position of the potential borrower. Okay, the potential borrower anticipates of rising interest rate. So, bila interest naik, what will happen to the price of FKB3? When interest increase, the price of FKB3 will decrease. Maksudnya sekarang, the price of FKB3 is still high. So, what we will do, we will sell the CLIBOR futures or FKB3 now because we want to hedge against the rising interest rate. Let's take a look at this example. A company has a special short-term borrowing. Okay, you has a company has a special short-term borrowing for 500 million. Okay, in this agreement, the company will be charged 2.5% above CLIBOR rate. Currently, the CLIBOR or the cash rate is 3.5% and expected to rise. So, yang 3.5% ni expected to rise steadily within 3 months. Okay. Today is early June. Okay, early June tu baru buat agreement. Today is early April. Okay, on this early April, we just entered an agreement bahawasanya we will borrow later on in June. Bulan June nanti baru kita nak start pinjam. Okay, so today is early April. June FKB3 are quoting at 96.05 in the Bursa Malaysia Derivative Berhad. Assuming in mid-June, the cash rate closed at 5.1. Ha, nampak tak? 3.5 in April. In June, the interest rate has increased to 5.1. And June FKB3 at 95. As you can see, when interest increased from 3.5 to 5.1, FKB3 previously 96.05 has decreased, okay, to 95. Show your hedging benefits as measured by effective interest rate. Okay, first and foremost, of course, again, we will calculate the number of contract. So, how much borrowing you will require or you will do in June, 500 million ringgit. So, you divide with 1 million ringgit, the size of the contract, you will get 500 contracts. Okay, so today in the cash market, you expect to borrow 500 million ringgit in June, but you afraid the CLIBOR or the interest rate will increase later. So, what will happen will when interest increase, the interest payment or the cost of borrowing will also increase. Okay. If you expect the interest will increase, the futures price will fall. Who are you? You are potential borrower in this case. Okay. When interest goes up, FKB3 will fall, meaning currently the price of FKB3 is still high. Bila harga masih tinggi, what should we do? We should open our position by selling 500 June FKB3 contracts at 96.05. So later, kita pun borrow lah. Bila later kita tu in June lah kan? Saya tak letak terpulang, tak nak letak pun tak apa. You will borrow 500 million in CLIBOR market at what? At 7.6. Datang mana 7.6? Okay. Yes. Interest memang 3.5. Okay. Naik kepada 5.1. Tapi here, it has been mentioned that the company will charge 2.5% above CLIBOR. CLIBOR originally 3.5. Increase to 5.1. But this 5.1, okay, dia akan charge pula extra 2.5%. Meaning to say all together, alright, the company tu akan charge you how much? 7.6%. Okay, the bank will charge you 7.6%. Okay? Ha, gitu kisah dia. So, be careful. Alright, originally 3.5. Yes, it increased to 5.1. Okay, boleh je kalau tak ada 2.5. But this question is special. Alright, it mentioned earlier that the company will be charged by the bank extra by 2.5% above CLIBOR. Okay? So, what happened pula in the futures market, you will close out your position, you will buy back the 500 June FKB3 contract at now price 95. Nampak tak harga jatuh bila interest naik? Okay. So, how can we determine the hedging profit or loss again in your futures market? Selling price minus buying price. Okay, 96.05 minus 95. times 100 basis point times 500 contract times 25 ringgit, you will gain 1.3125 million ringgit in futures market. In the cash market, all right, who are you? In this case, you are borrower, so you will need to pay the interest. So your interest payment will be how much? 500 million ringgit times 0.076 times 90 days over 360, you will have to pay interest how much? 9.5 million. So this is your outflow. This is your expenses. Okay, your expense. Tak ada tanda negatif anak-anak, but you have to alert. This one will be your outflow, not your inflow, because this is interest payment. So to calculate the net effect, jangan tambah dua-dua. This one is inflow, this one is outflow. It's okay. Ini nak minus positif, nak minus yang ni ke, yang ni nak minus yang ni ke, it's okay. As long as jangan tambah dua-dua. So, suppose you have to pay interest by how much? 9.5 million. But because you gain 1.3 million here, so see, amount of interest that you have to pay bukan lagi 9.5, tapi tinggal 8.1875 million only. See? Why? Because dah tercover 1.3 juta lebih lah. Okay, part of the interest payment, alright, has been covered by the futures profit. So, net effect you, you punya jumlah interest payment dah kurang. Okay, tinggal 8.1875 juta. So, how to calculate the effective interest rate? Again, you take the net effect. Ignore the negative sign there. Alright, simply just take the value. Divide with the principal amount. Okay, times 360 days over 90 days, you will get 6.55%. Okay, seolahnya apa? Kita tak bayar pun interest 7.6. Sebab part of the interest has been covered by the profit in the futures. Kita cuma bayar interest by how much? 6.55%. So, what can we conclude? So, please ignore the negative sign. What can we conclude? The borrowing effectively cost the company only 6.55% interest payment with hedging compared to 7.6% without hedging, which is higher. So, again, the hedging is a success in this case lah. Okay, let's do one more exercise. This is question from June 2013, question 3A. Bina Perkasa Berhad has signed an agreement for short-term financing of 100 million ringgit in mid-November 2012 with a foreign bank. Okay. Has signed agreement for short-term financing. Another word for financing tu maksudnya you perlukan pembiayaan. You are borrower. Okay. Right. The financing rate has been fixed at 1% above the cash rate. Ha, dia dah cakap kat sini. Alright, 1% above the cash rate. Okay, and will take effect from the third week of December 2012. Okay, sekarang mid-November, you akan start meminjam in December for 90 days. Currently, 3-month LIBOR and December FKB3 are quoted at 6.5% and 92.5 respectively. Later in December, the cash and futures market converge. Okay, kali ni they converge at 91.5. Okay, this one kena tengok betul-betul, faham kan? Okay, elaborate the strategy that the company should implement, state the rationale. Okay, jawapan for this one is apa? Alright, since you are the intending borrower, okay, what you will do short hedging in the futures market, alright, in order to hedge against the interest rate risk. Okay, when the interest goes up, the price of futures contract will fall. So by doing short hedging, okay, you can cover the increase in the interest payment through the profit in the futures market. That's how to answer question number one. Okay, alright. And then to answer question number two, determine the benefits of the strategy against the risk exposure by effective interest rate. Dia minta kita kira effective interest rate, and finally comment on the benefit. Okay, so let's highlight what have been given to us. Okay, you need short term financing 100 million in December. IO currently, interest is 6.5%. December FKB3 is 92.5. Interest rate will be charged 1% above CLIBOR when the borrowing take effect in December. And later, the cash and futures market will converge at 91.5. Okay. Alright. Oh, ada jawapan tu kat sini. When the borrowing takes effect in December, Right, the company afraid the interest will increase, and this will increase the cost of borrowing. So when I goes up, the FKBT will fall. Therefore, you should do short H today. Okay, and then for question two, you will calculate the number of contract. 100 million borrowing divided with 1 million contract size, 100 contract altogether. So this is your outline. Expect to borrow 1 million in December. Write down everything, and then you will enter futures market by opening your position by selling 100 December FKBT contract at 92.5. And then later on, okay, this one, tengok betul-betul eh. In this, okay, later you borrow lah. Tadi expect to borrow. In December, you will borrow. Okay, you will borrow at berapa? At, okay, dia kata cash market and futures market converge at 91.5. Ini dalam bentuk index form. Okay, maksudnya harga kat sini 91.5. Bila converge, maksudnya this one dalam bentuk interest. How to get the value? 100 minus 91.5. You will get 8.5. Inilah interest dia. 8.5% interest equals to 91.5 dalam bentuk index. But, soalan cakap, you will be charged 1% above the cash rate. Okay, originally asal dia berapa? 6.5. Lepas tu dia naik kepada 8.5. Again, macam mana dapat 8.5? Because futures and cash converge. To get this value, you take 100 minus 91.5. You get 8.5. But you have to plus another 1%. Because clearly mentioned, alright, the Bina Perkasa will be charged 1% above the CLIBOR rate waktu ni. Okay. So, ada dua kali meningkat. Maksudnya dia meningkat macam ni je, 6.5 kepada 8.5. Tapi ada extra charge pula 1%. Okay? Kalau tak ada, maksudnya 8.5 sajalah. But dalam kes ni ada another 1%. So, you will borrow the 100 million ringgit at 9.5. Okay? Kat sini tak payah nak tambah-tambah apa. Merely take the index 91.5%. Sebab kat sini bukan you nak pinjam ke apa. This one is merely about selling and buying the futures contract. Okay. Baru keluar converged. Okay. 8.5 because converged datang mana 100 minus 91.5. Okay. And then we will calculate your futures profit. Macam biasa. Take the selling price minus buying price. Times 100 basis point. Times 100. Times 75. You will gain 250,000 in futures market. In the cash market, it is your interest payment. Okay. How much you borrow 100 million times 0.095 here. Times 90 over 360 days. How much is your outflow? 2.375 million. So, ini outflow, ini profit inflow. So, inflow ni menyebabkan you punya interest dah berkurang kepada 2.125 million only. Okay. So, how to calculate the effective interest rate? Net effect over the principal times 360 over 90 days. You will get 8.5%. Nampak macam kita pinjam at 9.5. Tapi, the value give you 8.5%. The effective interest rate is only 8.5%. Kenapa? Part of the interest payment has been covered by the profit made in the futures market. So, what we can say, the borrowing effectively cost the company only 8.5% interest payment with hedging compared to 9.5% without hedging, which is higher. Okay? Alright. So, that is one example. Okay, so I want you to do another two question as your exercise, which is June 2018 question 1 and July 2017 also question 1. So look for these two past year questions and try to do both of them. Okay, thank you. We shall meet again in your next video.